Let's take a quick minute to talk about medications that treat erectile dysfunction. These class of medications are named for their mechanism of action. We call them for short PDE5 inhibitors, which stands for phosphodiesterase 5 inhibitors. These medications interact with our existing nitric oxide system and inhibit the enzyme that breaks it down. So let's start at the beginning. So you may already know that when somebody takes nitroglycerin, they are taking it because they have chest pain. And these medications work to relieve that chest pain or angina because of its ability to deliver nitric oxide to the blood vessels in that area. Chest pain is something that occurs when we're not getting adequate blood flow to the muscle of the heart, which usually means that there's some inability of the vessels to dilate. So how does this work? Well, you see, naturally, we make our own nitric oxide. If we look at a blood vessel, and then we look really close at a blood vessel, what we see is that on the inside of a vessel, we have a really delicate tissue called endothelium. And that endothelium is backed up right against smooth muscle. Whenever blood flow increases inside of a vessel, the endothelium is likely, in some cases, to get damaged. Remember, our blood isn't just fluid, there's stuff floating around in it. There's red blood cells and white blood cells, and something might hit that really delicate endothelium. So when blood flow increases, it increases something we call shear stress. That increase in shear stress triggers a natural cascade from the endothelium signaling to the smooth muscle to relax, to make more room in the vessel, and work as a protection against any damage to the inside of itself. This cascade involves nitric oxide. So let's take a look at just the cellular level. So if we have an endothelial cell butted up against a smooth muscle cell, the increase in velocity of blood flow, increasing this shear stress, is going to trigger a cascade. This cascade, or the eNOS pathway, begins with L-arginine being converted eventually into nitric oxide, which is a gas. Nitric oxide can diffuse into the smooth muscle cell and through a series of intracellular mechanisms can lead to the development of an intracellular signal that will eventually give us relaxation. When that smooth muscle relaxes, that allows the vessel to dilate so that we can have more space for blood flow through the vessel. If there's more blood flow through the vessel, we now don't have the lactic acid building up in the chest that would exist because we've shifted from aerobic to anaerobic respiration. That's what causes pain. All right, so this is our natural pathway. And what does this have to do with erectile dysfunction? Well, if we think about this pathway and how nitric oxide in general is associated with vasodilation, and then we think about erection, in order for somebody to have an erection, we need to have the ability for blood vessels to dilate to maintain the erection. In the same way that we make nitric oxide in response to increased shear stress, this is the same mechanism that occurs when blood flow increases to the genitals as a response to any kind of arousing information. Maybe it's sight, sound, sometimes just a breeze in the wind. when blood flow increases to the genitals, we have the same triggering cascade. And as long as somebody has nice compliant vessels that are able to dilate, then we can have this response. However, with things like aging that make vessels more stiff and less compliant, and atherosclerosis, which has to do with the deposition of cholesterol inside of vessels, sometimes vessels aren't able to have that dilatory response. So we can take advantage of our knowledge that nitric oxide is a vasodilator by giving nitric oxide donors to induce this cascade. Theoretically, then, you could give somebody L-arginine and they would experience that vasodilatory response and there would be no problem. However, there's one extra piece of the puzzle. That intracellular signaling mechanism, the cyclic GMP that's created in order for this response to happen, it doesn't stay around forever. Eventually, it's broken down, and it is broken down by an enzyme called phosphodiesterase 5. And when PDE5 disassembles this cyclic GMP cascade, we now have the end of dilation. We stop the erectile response. That means if we're treating erectile dysfunction, not only can we take advantage of nitric oxide donors, we also need to prevent the erection from stopping by giving something that inhibits the enzyme that would stop that cascade. So we're looking at medications that give some nitric oxide and also inhibit the breakdown of it. So medications like sildenafil or Viagra, vardenafil or Levitra, and tadalafil, sold as Cialis, are all medications that act as nitric oxide donors, but specifically PDE5 inhibitors. So they allow the blood vessels to dilate and then also prolong that dilation by preventing enzymatic breakdown of the ENOS cascade. One thing that does differ between these medications, even though they have the same basic mechanism of action, is that Cialis has a longer length of activity, where something like Viagra or Levitra might just have a 2-hour window that it can work within. Cialis can work for up to 6 hours, and it's marketed to those who want to have more spontaneity in their lovemaking. You should not mix these medications with any other drugs that increase nitric oxide, which brings us back to the beginning. One of those drugs is nitroglycerin, which is nitric oxide. At those commercial ends, you'll see there is a warning that says, ask your doctor if you're healthy enough for sexual activity. That is not a joke. When somebody has a heart that maybe isn't as strong as it used to be, we can overtax it, have chest pain, and then what does somebody take for their chest pain? They take their nitroglycerin tablet. You will have nitric oxide on top of nitric oxide, leading to extreme vasodilation and possible shock called pharmacologic shock. We should also be careful of it with anyone with cardiac insufficiency or abnormalities because of reflex tachycardia. When we have a huge amount of vasodilation, the heart works a little bit harder and beats a little bit faster to try to regulate and smooth out our blood pressure. So, pharmacology friends, that is my mechanism of action for these medications used to treat erectile dysfunction, known as the class of PDE5 inhibiting medications. Hopefully you all learned something. I hope you did. Stay smart, everybody.